how many of you have ever done sports before? And how many of you have been injured while doing that sport?
Oh.
So I would like to introduce you to two former student athletes. The first is Patty Fomini Vong, a Flyer on our high school cheer team, and wide receiver and defensive back Kenny Booth. They were both unaware of the dangers they would face doing the sport that they love. Occasional bumps and bruises are expected when kids play sports, but more than 1.35 million children last year were in the hospital due to sports-related injuries. Studies show that more people get injured in sports than they do in car accidents. Are sports becoming too dangerous? There are so many risks that come along with sports, and not many people realize how many there are and just how serious they can be. Some people might argue that all injuries are avoidable and that only people that don't pay attention and are dumb get injuries, but in reality, injuries aren't avoidable. For example, in football, if you get tackled and you hit your head and get a concussion, like, the only way to avoid stuff like that was to quit the sport. Like, it's stuff that comes along with the sport. Now, not all injuries are very serious. Some minor injuries include pulling a muscle, sprains, minor strains, and something as simple as like a black eye. These are the most common sport injuries. With these injuries, you'll be back to doing the sport within a week after icing and resting. It's easy for injuries like these to become more serious, though. For example, in cheerleading, girls are being thrown 10 to 20 feet in the air, and if something happens and the bases don't catch them, there can be very serious injuries, such as broken bones, concussions, dislocations, and fractures. Now, some coaches tell their athletes just to suck it up and go back into the sport and keep going even though they're injured, which is probably one of the worst things that you could do because you can further injure yourself and you'll be out longer than you would have been if you would have just sat out. There are between an estimated 1.3 and 3.8 million sports-related concussions in the United States every year, mostly linked to cheer and football. Football resulted in both the highest number of pediatric injuries and the highest concussion rate, which is 40 per every 10,000 athletes, and cheerleading has the second, which is 15 per every 10,000 athletes. There are so many risks that come along with tumbling also. When cheerleaders are doing flips, there's a chance that they might fall and slip and get injured. More than 46.5 million children, ages 6 to 19, are involved in sports, and more than 1.35 million of them are sent to the hospital due to injuries related to sports. Some people have walked away from injuries with minor falls, while others are left with more serious ones. Remember those two student athletes I mentioned at the beginning of this? Patty will never walk or talk again. She was struck in the chest, causing her heart to stop pumping, leaving her nearly breathless. The 45 minutes she went without oxygen left her with a brain damage, causing her to be permanently paralyzed. And Kenny suffered a major concussion while making a tackle in the last quarter of the game. He was rushed to the hospital with major brain injuries. He underwent two surgeries, but nothing helped. He passed away the morning of Monday, October 5th, 2017, at age 17. Kenny was the fourth high school student football player to die because of a sports-related injury in the month of September of 2015. As you can see, all injuries are serious, but not all are as serious as this. So I'd like to show a video real quick. So those are just some examples of injuries that can occur. So with that, I would like to say, please stay safe while doing sports. Thank you. Oh, nice.